Well, last time I covered the Emporia smart plugs, I mentioned that I had a Vue in my house as well, and a lot of you have been asking to cover, for me to cover this device. So I'm going to do this for you today. This is the most basic option, which basically only captures the entire load of your house via the two halves of the split phase that come into your North American home via two inductive clamps. I am also going to show you a little bit of the higher end version and how it uses sub-circuit clamps as well. I do have a couple of spares, so I'll cover that as well. But first things first, let's get this unboxed and I'll show you what's in there. So if you buy the basic one, this is what you're gonna see. Your main hub, which has ports for a lot of these sub-clamps, which you only get with the higher end version. And you have a Wi-Fi antenna BNC connector, and you have a little 4-pin Molex, which hooks into this. What this does is it powers the actual device via one of your existing split phase 120-volt circuits. I'll show you exactly what that ends up meaning too. They do supply you with two lead wires and some wire nuts. It's not copacetic to put multiple wires into a breaker, at least in the United States. So what they usually have you do is remove after shutting down a circuit, and I would have an electrician do this. It's not even legal for homeowners to touch electrical panels in some municipalities, so certainly check on that. But I digress. Shut down the circuit, unscrew the actual lead wire, screw in one of these, and then wire nut that existing circuit to the Emporia and this and the existing circuit, and that's more acceptable. So anyway, that's why those are there, and we'll get into that once I actually put this into my panel. But you have the two master clamps here, and like I mentioned before, these are inductive current clamps, very similar to a fancier multimeter. So these appear to be extremely accurate. I've had it on my house and home garage for over a year. And yeah, they're very accurate down to very, very low wattages. So I'm gonna open up one of my panels here and I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna do. So here's the inside of my 100 amp service. You can see it's pretty much full with the exception of my upper right. I've got a spare 100 in there. That was actually the original main breaker. I thought it was bad, but it turns out it was just overheating. So anyway, these are the rest of my circuits and I'm going to be putting those primary clamps on these two wires. And again, don't do this live. So if you end up touching it, if it's even legal for you to touch it, which I don't recommend you do anyway, and you should be hiring an electrician, make sure that the service is pulled, the meter's pulled, your electrical company knows, and then they can re-tag your meter and turn it back on later. So with that out of the way, what I'm gonna end up doing is shutting all that down outside. I'm at an association, so there's a breaker outside, which is actually really, really handy. And then I'm going to find probably my smallest circuit here. Unfortunately, there's no 15 amps because this is all commercial. So I'll probably end up pulling the circuit for my garage door opener and wire nutting the Emporia into that. I will need, actually, this is a split neutral, so it's a little bit better. We'll need a neutral as well to power up the Emporia. And then we'll get the clamps on the primary. And that might be all I end up doing on this panel, because I kind of know, you know, the electric car, I know which one's going where, things like that. So anyway, I digress. Let me get that in and figure out where the heck I'm going to put in this Wi-Fi antenna. All right, so made some progress. Got it all disconnected. Got it installed, at least basically. And then I've got the mains turned back on here. All right, so I think I'm going to end up putting the main box up top in here just because there's more room, and I'm still not exactly sure what I'm going to do for the Wi-Fi antenna. There's wood all the way around this, so I don't think I have much option. I think I'm going to have to notch it and run it out right through the top, which is really not copacetic, but I don't think I have much else for option, unfortunately. Oh, I forgot to say, worth noting, there is an identifier on each one of these clamps, and it should be arrow pointing toward the breaker. All right, just flipped on the breaker. The black wire is load 1, red wire is load 2, blue wire is load 3, white is neutral. I have found that if you just hook up black to your load on either of the legs of your split phase 240, it reads voltage just fine. So on the off chance you have a 15 amp 240 volt circuit, you can use both. I just wouldn't recommend undoubling up the wires into the breakers. Like I said, that's usually a no-no. But I've got the clamps in facing the breaker. I've got things kind of out of the way. I'm not tying them to any high voltage because I don't really want any more crosstalk than there already will be. And yeah, this is really not ideal, but I'm just going to have to run the Wi-Fi antenna out and sandwich it. So anyway, I've got it powered up. I'm going to add it to the app real quick, and then we'll close it up and take a look. There we have it. Total usage, 2 kilowatts. Holy cow. I'm going to turn off the overhead lights and see how much that is. 550 watts. Anyway, that's pretty much all there is to it. If you have the fancier version, each one of these would go around the wire going into each sub-circuit on your panel. You can pick and choose. So you can, if you only want to monitor, for instance, your car charger or something like that, you can just put two of these in, one on each leg of that load, and they will show up in the GUI as well. And then you probably noticed all the other ports on the machine. The ones on the sides are what you use for these. So I bought two of the nicer ones, and I only ended up monitoring, I don't know, a handful of circuits. That's why I have so many of these left over. But on this one, I don't really care about monitoring any of the other circuits. So the overall is all I really care about. So these will go back into storage. But just in case you do have one of the fancier ones, you'll need those two. So here's panel two. And you can see what it looks like when you do add a couple of those circuit clamps. Just plug them in, cap off the rest of the holes. You should do that anyway. It does come with the little rubber plugs. And then you can see the main breaker as well. So yay. And yet another Emporia Vue install. This one's a little bit better set up for me to show you. So I've popped out one of the half-inch plugs in the bottom of this panel for the little Wi-Fi antenna. Next up, I'm going to be plugging in this little 4-pin modular Molex. And again, we're going to be using black. And we're going to tie that in with a wire nut and the included short wire lead to an existing circuit. This is just a 10 amp 110. It's not even in use anymore. And then we'll bring the white up to the neutral block. This panel shows you the difference between a neutral and a ground block if you happen to have both. Some homes don't. Neutral and ground typically are the same thing. So let's wire that in, get A and B connected to the clamps, which are actually going to be going on this panel over here through this grommet right here. So the Vue is going to be sitting down here, but it's actually going to be on this panel here. So again, I have my clamps up here. There is a diagram on the back side here, which has an arrow, and you want the arrow pointing to your breaker. Now I'm gonna go ahead and hook these up and get everything mounted and tidied up. So we have the hot bridged. I would still normally prefer give the Emporia its own breaker, but in this case, that's really just not possible. So booting up, we'll get everything loaded up in the app here. But yeah, this is a nice big panel. I'm actually pretty happy with how much room I have to work. And in the phone, in the Emporia app, simply go to devices, and then you can go through the setup. I'm showing it to you in pretty fast speed here. This is still real time, but I cut out the private Wi-Fi information and a few seconds of pause in a few of these steps, like configuring Vue. There's a firmware update. You will get this warning if you only plug in one of the two hot leads, then naming. But really, it's a pretty simple process. It uses Bluetooth to initially connect, and then you need 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi to finish everything up. But once that's done, you should get a full picture of your power consumption. And hey presto, we're good to button her back up.